Yo guys, hello and welcome to my first video on this channel. I decided to make a video about Greatsword. I saw a lot of YouTube videos about Greatsword and Jayen and how to play Greatsword, but they pretty much only showed the combos and everything. Like, they didn't show the complex stuff, like moveset and dodge reads and everything. I'm really missing that, and so I decided to just make it by my own. Yeah, as you can see, like I got Jayen to diamond. I also got him to level 44. That's pretty insane, because I mean I played him since he came out, basically. I'm going to talk about the best stance,
Training.
the moveset, so how to engage, how to play defense. I'm going to talk about the best free hit combos. Then I'm going to talk about the best bridge cancel combos. I'm going to talk about the dodge reads and other follow-ups. I'm going to talk about zero to deaths. I'm going to talk about six and the recovery. And finally, I'm going to talk about how to play in the air. So this video will definitely be long, but I want to summarize that all in one video. So yeah, that's basically my plan. Okay, so first let's begin with the stance. I'm just removing dexterity because I'm a dexterity hater. Like, I think that stance is pretty useless. Also on Jayen, because some people said that it would be good on Jayen because he has those he has just a lot of combos and a lot of low dodge windows, but it's actually not worth it. Let me say that, it's actually not worth it. And just play attack. That's pretty much the best stats, because he then just gets 7 attack. That's pretty insane, and I think it's definitely worth it to, yeah, play it with attack. Okay, let's go in the game. Actually, maps, Demon Island, especially flat maps are the best maps. So Small Nygma and the Great Hall and everything, they are not that good for Jayen. I mean, you can still play Jayen very good, but the best maps are actually flat maps like Demon Island, for example. Demon Island is actually the best tournament map for Jayen because it's long and it's flat. Okay, let me real quick change that to Mordex because then we get a 5 defense. 5 defense character. Okay. So, basically, I'm going to begin with the moveset. If you want to engage, the best engaging is actually dodge, dash into neutral light. So like this. This is definitely the best engage. It covers, oops, I misclicked. Wait. This covers a lot. Like, this covers really a big area. It hits grounded. It also hits enemies in the air. Oh, I didn't activate the hitboxes. Oh, come on. So as you can see, the hitboxes are pretty big. It's almost 180 degree. It hits enemies when they jump over you. It hits enemies in front of you. So dash into neutral light is your best approach option. You also have a pretty good range with it. Then, if you're a little bit closer to the enemy and, for example, move around, And then you're touching the ground. You can actually do sidelight. Sidelight is also pretty good. If you're close to the enemy, it's really fast. It also has a pretty good range. And all the starters from Jane have actually a little really small really small recovery frames. So like you can recover pretty fast. And yeah, Nuzlocke is probably the best one and the fastest and the one with the most possibilities after that. You know, the good thing about Sidelight, for example, is that they get thrown a little bit in the air, as you can see. And if they dodge, then they waste an air dodge. And an air dodge needs a lot more time to recover than a grounded dodge. That's really important. Also, the Neutralite, of course, also yeah, hit them above the floor. And yeah, and the downlight actually also, but he can't dodge. Also, if the enemy dodges a downlight, they will only dodge it grounded. I mean, I can show you. If, for example, okay, if actually the enemy dodges perfectly, then they will actually dodge in the air. That's pretty insane. So when the enemy is really good at dodging, he will waste his air dodge. That's pretty good. So then I will talk about yeah, engaging. Yeah, I about another option for engaging. Another option is especially if you want to finish, like if he's red or something, I don't know, let's say 100, 160 HP or something. Then you can dodge, jump into recovery. This hits grounded, it finishes pretty quick. On 5 dexterity, it finishes at 160 HP on 5 defense. Yeah, so that's really important to finish, and I really use this a lot. It's pretty much like you can really can't really punish it. It's really hard to punish because you can even slide away directly after this, and
Dominating.
it this move
Triple
comes
knockout.
this move comes often
Berserk.
really unexpected. But I would not spam this because then the enemy will probably dodge this. Another way of approaching is dodge jump into downlight and the grounded version. So, oops, dodge light grounded. I also really use this a lot against Lance player, for example, because yeah, if they maybe going for a sidelight and you know they're going for the sidelight, you can just dodge jump into down air. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Maybe a good thing to know is if you're dodge jumping, if you dodge, oh my god, if you dodge jumping and then turn around, you can actually do a side air. That's also working. But I would not recommend you to do the side air grounded because it has a lot of recovery frames and it's not that good. You don't have that good moves after this move to follow up. I would not recommend you to hit side air grounded. Also, if the player plays really grounded, so like if he always stay on the ground and wait for you to attack, you can actually engage with the downlight, with a dash downlight. So like dash downlight covers like the half of Demon Island. Demon Island is already a really big map. So on some maps you can just hit him from the one end of the map to the other edge. You know, that's pretty insane. And it's really quick. to hit a downlight. Yes, that's basically it for engaging. Yeah, now I'm going to talk about the best free hit combos. So the best starter for every starter, the best bridges and closes. I will begin with sidelight. Actually, I think the bridge after the sidelight, the best bridge is the downlight. Wait, it's the downlight. It has a 2 dodge window if you hit it correctly. But it can variate. But even if you hit close, then it's a 4 dodge window. But even
Unstoppable.
that's pretty good because they will most likely not dodge it. Okay, Greatsword to great dodge Greatsword. It's really hard. Some of you maybe may notice because you played against Greatsword, but dodging Greatsword is really hard. Even if it's a 4 dodge window, they will mostly not dodge this because it's really fast. And if you hit it far away, it's even a 2 dodge window. They will 90% they will not dodge this. After this, after the bridge of the neutral light, you can follow up with a sidelight because the sidelight is actually the best finisher, I think. After
Legendary.
the nerf, I mean before it was definitely downlight from the sidelight. Oops, from the sidelight finisher, it had a lot of force, but now it's yeah, the sidelight is just better. Definitely, it's faster, it's less recovery frames, even more force. So that's pretty insane. And it has a one
Godlike.
dodge window after the neutral
Triple
bridge.
knockout.
That's really good. Okay, going on with the neutral light, your most used engaged weapon. If the enemy is red, or generally also to do damage, I mostly go for neutral light, sidelight, sidelight. This just works insane. I don't know why, but 90% of the enemies will not
Triple
dodge this at
knockout.
all.
Godlike.
Neutral light, sidelight is neutral light, sidelight,
Rampage.
sidelight is so quick. They will not even have time to react to this. So even diamond players are most mo will mostly not dodge this. So for neutral light, it's neutral light, sidelight, sidelight. It's the best combo. Okay, now I'm going to explain you the best follow-ups for downlight. For downlight, it's actually downlight, neutral light, and sidelight. But you
Godlike.
can also do downlight, sidelight, sidelight. It's also pretty good.
Triple knockout.
But downlight, neutral light, sidelight has lower dodge windows, more damage, and it's pretty much better in everything. So, downlight, neutral light, sidelight is the best combo. Okay, and then I'm also talking about the down air because it's also really important. For down air, it's actually a down air, neutral light, side light. So this has really low dodge windows, like 1 and 2 dodge
Triple
window.
knockout.
And yeah, the enemies
Rampage.
will also not dodge this the most time, because this is also really, really, really hard to dodge, even maybe harder than neutral light, side light, side light. So you can actually go for this combo a lot. Yeah, that's basically it for the best free hit combos. I may want to explain you something. If you, for example, engage somebody with a neutral light, but he, for example, backdashes, or you basically just don't hit him, then you don't have to stop your attack. You can still go on with a side light and then a neutral finisher. You know, the neutral finisher is actually really hard to punish. So, like, whenever you don't hit a combo, you can just finish this combo with a neutral finisher. I mean, it also kills pretty quick, but not so quick than the side finisher, but it's pretty much undodgeable. Because as you can see, you basically jump, and that makes it really hard for the enemy to engage you. Because when he comes from above, he gets hit. Because as you can see, the hitbox is also pretty good. It's like really far away, and the hitbox really protects you. So, for example, like I'm doing this a lot. When, for example, I engage somebody, I don't hit a. I see that I didn't hit the neutral light. Then I'm just go on with a side light. If they try to punish you from the ground, then the side light will catch them. And if they try to engage from above, then the neutral light will hit them. So this really works a lot. So because the enemies try to punish you because you missed the neutral light, but you can just go on the combo. They will not expect this, and you can get easy damage or maybe even an easy kill. But don't spam this, because if you do this all the time, the enemy will just wait and then punish you. So just use it wisely. The first times it most likely will work, but it will not work when you spam it all the time. So that's really important. Okay, now I'm going to talk about dodge reads and follow-up. So that's basically the most important thing on Greatsword. You have basically infinite amount of potential for dodge reads, because you can get dodge reads out of every light attack. You can get dodge reads out of a down light. You can get dodge reads out of a side light. You can get dodge reads out of a neutral light, a down air, and even a side air. But you should not you should not do the side air grounded. It's just not good. Remember. So to begin with with dodging in. If the enemy dodges in, let's say you approach with the neutral light, just normal. Wait, let me first set the damage down. Let's say you approach with a neutral light, and the enemy will dodge in. By the way, actually, you can do the neutral light to side light almost every time. The enemy will not dodge this, okay? In 90% of the cases, they will not dodge this. Even I can't dodge this. Like, this is really, I mean, like, really hard to dodge. It's really quick, okay? And the bot, so, but the bot will dodge it because he's programmed. But I can tell you, even the diamond enemies will most likely not dodge this. So, let's say I hit a neutral light into side light, and he dodges in. Then you can basically follow up with bridge cancel combos, okay? I first may have to explain bridge cancel combos for you who don't know them. For the side light, okay, I will begin with the side light, because that's actually the hardest one, and the one you have to learn the most. If you do a starter and a bridge, so side light, neutral light, for example, and then you chase dodge after that, and you can do the same attack than the bridge. So like if I do side light, neutral light, then I can chase dodge into neutral light opener again. That means I can do another bridge and another finisher, or I can even do after the bridge, after the second free hit combo, I can just infinite go on. I can just do starter bridge, chase dodge, starter bridge, chase dodge, starter bridge, and then I can finish it with a finisher. But the enemies will dodge it, so you can't do it infinite. But if you, let's say you hit a side light neutral light, then you have to hold, oops, then you have to hold down your dodge button, and while you hold it down, you also hold down the buttons for the neutral light. So A and WV. So you will hold A, WV, your dodge button, and your light attack button. Those four buttons. After oops, I even failed because I even failed because it's really hard. You know, it's also really important to hold down your dodge button while you're in while you're doing the neutral light, because if you're just trying to chase dodge and after that and attack after that, and then something like that will happen. You will just chase dodge and you will not hit the enemy. So you have to hold down both while you do the first neutral light. Okay. Really, you have to really practice this a lot. This is really important. Really, really, really important. Oops. Okay. Then after the chase dodge neutral light, you have a new opener, the neutral light, and yeah, as already said, the best free hit combo for the neutral light. Oh wait, I think I didn't set it, but the best combo for the neutral light is side light. I think I don't know if I said it. Maybe I said it. Maybe not. But again, best combo for the neutral light is neutral light, side light. This works a lot. Low dodge windows and really good falls. And I don't know if I said this also, but for downlight, it's downlight. Yeah, I said this. I said this. It's fine. I'm sorry that I'm a little bit confused. So after the neutral, after the chase dodge and the neutral light opener, you want to do a double side light. So you're doing chase dodge and then neutral light, side light, side light. So it will look like this. Wait. This is the thing you want to learn. Okay, that's really important. Let it become your, let it get, no, let it become your muscle memory. Okay, then go on with the downlight. That's a little bit easier because if you want difference, I said that the best free hit combo is downlight, neutral light, side light. But if you want to do a bridge cancel combo, you actually want to do a downlight, side light into another side light. Okay? But you can, I don't know if you can. You can even go on with a neutral light as well. Maybe you should even do this. I didn't use that, but that's maybe actually better. Yeah, I think that's better. Okay, you know what? Don't do the same mistake as me and learn to do the neutral light chase dodge neutral light. I mean, that's basically the same thing as side light neutral light into side light neutral light into chase dodge neutral light. That's basically the same thing. So you're doing downlight, neutral light into chase dodge, neutral light, and then you can again follow up with side light. Actually, when I think about it, I think, I mean, that's also pretty good. So like downlight, neutral light into chase dodge, neutral light into side light. But I think another good option, and maybe that's even better, is side light, neutral light, side light. So after the chase dodge, you're doing side light, neutral light, side light. So it's down light, side light into. Oops. Now I'm so used to the neutral light into neutral light. Oh. What am I doing? No. Okay. Let's focus. So, you're doing downlight, sidelight into gravity cancel, sidelight into neutral light bridge into sidelight finisher. So it's downlight, sidelight, gravity cancel, sidelight, neutral light, and sidelight finisher. That's actually also a good combo, and I think sidelight, neutral light, sidelight has more force than the neutral light, sidelight. I don't know what's better, but maybe you should actually use downlight into neutral light. I think that's actually better. So, you know what? Just learn this first at first. So, downlight. Okay. So, downlight into neutral light into gravity cancel, neutral light into sidelight. Learn this first. And if you also have time for that, then just maybe learn additional, because it can also be very useful. Downlight, sidelight into gravity cancel, into chase dodge sidelight into neutral light into sidelight. So sidelight, neutral light, sidelight after the chase dodge. Okay. Then continue with the neutral light. On the neutral light, you actually have to use the sidelight bridge. So you're using neutral light, sidelight bridge, sidelight, neutral light, sidelight. So it looks like this. Yeah. So nothing really much to say about it. That's like the most important bridge cancel combo for the neutral light. So I will say it again. It's neutral light, sidelight, neutral light, sidelight. Okay, and yeah, after the sidelight, after the second si after the first sidelight, you chase dodge into another sidelight. So like this. You will learn this. This is not as difficult as the neutral light into chase dodge neutral light. And then another thing is with the down air. If you hit a down air and then neutral light, you maybe you can think it. It's down air, neutral air, and then again the. I don't know if that's even. Yeah, that's possible. So down air, neutral light into chase dodge, neutral light into sidelight. So again, just after the chase dodge, neutral light, sidelight. That's just your thing. So it's downlight, sidelight, and then chase dodge. No. Downlight, neutral light, chase dodge, neutral light, sidelight. Too many downlights, too many sidelights, too many. I don't know. Yeah, that's basically it for the bridge cancel combos. Now let's go back to the dodge reads, because you need the bridge cancel moves for the dodge reads to get bigger value out of them. Okay, for example, your enemy dodges in. You know your enemy dodges in because he dodged in the whole match, and you know he's going to dodge in, or you just predict that he dodges in because a lot of player dodges in. Let's say I'm hitting a neutral light sidelight. Then I can so let's just pretend I hit a neutral light sidelight. I can't do it because it has dodge window and the dodge at the end board dodges perfectly. But I hit a neutral light into a sidelight and he dodges in. Then I dash back. And then I'm just doing another neutral light into sidelight into so bam bam neutral light into sidelight into chase dodge sidelight into Neutralite and Sidelight. I know it sounds a little bit hard, maybe, but it's nothing else than this. What you just have learned, you know? This is the thing you have to learn, and then you're just doing this combo after the dodge read. So you're just maybe approaching with Neutralite, Sidelight, dodge back, and then you're just doing the bridge cancel combo for the Neutralite. So Neutralite, Sidelight, Gravity Cancel. No. Neutralite, Sidelight, Gravity Cancel, Sidelight, and then Neutralite and another Sidelight finisher. Yeah, that's basically a dodge read when you when he dodges in. I can show you. I can show it to you. But actually, the bot would actually dodge the last finisher or maybe even the bridge if you don't time it perfectly. But the normal player will don't dodge this. Maybe the normal player will be able to dodge will be able to dodge the last finisher, but that's not a big of the deal. You still deal so much damage. You can be happy. So, I'm hitting a Neutralite Yeah, you saw this. The last bridge, the enemy will actually be not able to dodge the Neutralite bridge. The last Neutralite bridge. What you just saw, that's just the bot, he dodges perfectly. Just do it anyway, okay? Yeah, that's basically it for the in dodges. Let's say he dodges away. When he dodges away and you realize that he often dodges away, then you can just then you can just dash into Sidelight, for example. You can also just downlight. That's another possibility you have. It's up to you. I maybe recommend you to go for the Sidelight because it's quicker and yeah, maybe you can do a little bit more damage out of it. Let's say you're just hitting. By the way, I'm just hitting in Neutralite because the dodge bot dot the bot dodges perfectly. But you should always go for a Neutralite Sidelight. So always go for Neutralite Sidelight. You will be able to hit this 90% of the time. Okay, it's worth it. And when you realize that your enemy actually can dodge this out, which is really rare, even I mostly don't can't dodge this out. Then you can just do a Neutralite, but that's really rare. I mean, I'm Diamond and even the people on Diamond actually can't really dodge this because I don't know, man. It's great sword. Okay, so let's say I'm hitting the Neutralite Sidelight and he dodges away. Then yeah, just Sidelight. And if you see the map is too short to do the full bridge cancel combo we just learned before. Then you actually have the opportunity to chase dodge behind your enemy and just go to the other direction. So it's like this then. Oh wait. You know? So if you see that the space is not enough to do your bridge cancel combo, just turn around. That's even hard for me. Oops. What am I doing? You see, you know what I mean. Just chase dodge behind your enemy and then do the regular combo. So to summarize this, you're for example hitting a Neutralite Sidelight and he's dodging away, then you dodge towards him, then you do a Sidelight Neutralite. Yeah, then you do a Sidelight Neutralite, Then you chase dodge behind him, and then you just continue with the neutralize, sidelight, sidelight. You know the deal. Okay. That's it for the dodges away. You really have to practice all those things. It really takes a while to get used to it. Like, I was... Oh my god, like, I was almost crying when I tried to learn all those chain combos. Because it's so much. I know, it's hard, I know. But that's the deal if you want to be a good great sword player and not one of those stupid spammer. You don't want to be one of those. Okay, yeah, let's cover the neutral spot dodges. You know, never spot dodge against greatsword, okay? That's rule number one to if you play against greatsword. Dodge any direction. Dodge in the freaking ground or something. But don't spot dodge, okay? Please just don't spot dodge against greatsword. I mean, I can show you, if even if I'm, like, doing pretty much just a normal combo. Oops, okay, that was a bad example. You know, you see, he just spot dodged. I didn't even dodge read at him or something. But if you spot dodge, the greatsword can just, yeah, rip you completely. But the real case is, even on diamond, a lot, so like maybe the half of the player or something spot dodges, and you can use this so good to destroy your enemies. I get so many 0-to-deaths because I don't know, I dodged them 3 or 4 times in a row. This is also a thing you can learn to, like, after even, so like, to learn when he gets his dodge back after a dodge read, and then because if you know he always spot dodges, just dodge read him again, and then you just do another bridge cancel combo, which are 6 hits. No, 5 hits actually, and then he's dead, and that's insane. So you can actually learn this, but don't prioritize on this to learn this. It's more important to learn the basic bridge cancel combo with one dodge read. That's the thing you're really going to use mostly. Okay. So, let's say you're just hitting your neutralite sidelight, he spot dodges. You can, for example, if you don't have space, enough space on the stage, just you can just hit any attack. You can hit a downlight. Wait. You can hit a. Oops. Oh, come on. You can chase dodge behind him when he spot dodges, and then you can just do your normal bridge cancel combo, like, you know, neutralite, sidelight, chase dodge into sidelight, neutralite into another sidelight. You know the deal. Or you can do a downlight, for example. You can also do downlight into neutralite into chase dodge, neutralite, sidelight, sidelight. Or you can do a sidelight neutralite into chase dodge neutralite into sidelight and another sidelight. I know if he spot dodges, you can do basically anything. But I will recommend you to go for the neutralite because it's the most easiest. It's just very easy to hit. So yeah, like this. And the normal player will not dodge in the end, because nobody's going to time this perfectly. Maybe this will happen sometimes, but this will just happen rare, okay? Just trust me. Oops. Yeah. Yeah, that's basically it. We have to write one thing. Okay, sorry for the short interruption. Okay, then I'm going to talk. Oh yeah, wait, I forgot one thing. If they dodge us up, if they dodge up in any direction. So let's say you have a neutral side light and they dodge up, and you can just follow up to with, for example, neutral light, but you it's kind of tricky to hit this. So if you hit your neutral light side light, you can yeah, you can maybe wait a little bit. But you know, if he just spams this button, he will maybe get away. That's a problem. So if you know he dodges up, which will really happen rare, okay? Like I really don't see a lot of people who are dodging up. Okay, that's really rare. The most will spot dodge or dodge in a direction, but to dodge up is really rare against Red's World, against Great's World. But if it's the case and he dodges up, and he dodges up, for example, all the time, you can do something like that, like neutral light into side light. You do your neutral light side light, and then you can down light into neutral light because down light neutral light is true. You know, okay, that should be true. And even if that's not true, it's just even like it's not every time true, but normally it's true. Even it's if it's not true, it has a dodge window from one with it has dodge a one dodge window or something. So the enemy will mostly not dodge this. This is really very rare that they dodge this. So, let's say you hit your neutral light side light, and you can just oops, yeah. If I would do this correctly, I'm not using this really because there are basically just no player who is dodging up. That's really rare. Yeah, but if that's the case, you can also do so. Like, if you dodge up, you have the possibilities to wait and then do another neutral light. This yeah happen like I'm using this mostly because yeah one thing I maybe can also say if you if your enemies dodges always another way you can actually react kind of to dodges. So let's say you hit your neutral light side light and he dodges and you think he dodges in and you dot and you backdash. Then you can actually still you have to practice this fast enough get a downlight so just dodge downlight because this has so enormous range so you can actually react to dodges and then you can even after the downlight there you can maybe just do downlights wait downlight neutral light sidelight or you can even do a bridge cancel combo so like downlight down light neutral light into chase dodge neutral light into side light side light but if you don't have space then you you know you just have to then you just have to chase dodge into the other direction behind the enemy so side light neutral light and then you dodge behind the enemy and yeah you really have to practice this as well. Yeah, that's also the case for the up dodges. So if you, for example, predict that he dodges in, you dodge back. Oh wait. And you think that he dodges in, but he actually dodges up, then you can still react to this. If your enemy doesn't spam his button like a ape or something, then you maybe can even hit him. With a with another neutral light then. So let's say you hit the neutral light side light, you do, you but you predict an in dodge, so you dodge back, but then he dodges up. Then you just dodge forward and side light, so just like your engager. So it's neutral light into side light, where neutral light into side light, And then you can still do, use this. And when you dodge back, the enemy will not will mostly not spam his button anymore, and he want to go down and maybe fast fall, and that's the time where you can dodge forward and neutral light, and then you can just do a full push cancel combo on him. So it looks like this. Oh, oops, that I kind of fucked up there, but when you really see that you have no space here, at the end, then you can just do instead of a bridge, you can just do starter into finisher. But this is something specific. You should not yet especially learn this. And yeah, that's not so important to really learn. But you can, of course, learn this if you mastered all other techniques. That's no problem. Okay, what other things I wanted to talk about? Let me look up in my notes. Yeah, some other follow-ups. Yeah, I wanted to talk also like about, for example, another option. If he dodges up, you neutralizing sidelight, he dodges up, you can actually just jump side air. This just works really safe. It's pretty safe to fray safe. Pretty safe to throw out, and the side air actually has also a lot of force and can sometimes even on a little bit higher damage finish. So this is a really good follow-up. It's really easy. I mean, it's only one hit, but still, it's something. You should really be aware of that combo. Yeah, and another possibility, you can also do neutralite sidelight and then just jump into neutral air. You know, neutral air is has a lot of force, has almost the force of the recovery, so you can finish pretty early with the neutral air. It's really quick and has a lot of insane hitboxing, so I would recommend to go for a neutral air. That's probably your best option if he dodges up, and you know that he always dodges up, and that he also that he spams his button every time, so you can't hit the neutral light. But only if that's the case. So only if you can't follow up with a neutral light bridge cancel, you know, then you can maybe try to follow up with a neutral light, with a neutral air. Yeah, of course you can also, but this is a little bit difficult. Go for a down, go for a down light and then a neutral light. This is a little bit like even like I didn't practice it, so I maybe have to practice this. Yeah, like this. This I mean, then you have additional the down light, but this is pretty hard, and I don't know if it's worth it to go for. I would just recommend you to go for the neutral air, and you're good to go. Then I wanted to talk about some like zero to death things. They are not directly zero to deaths, but for example, in the beginning I talked about the neutral light finisher, so it's pretty unpunishable. Another really good thing about the neutral light finisher is, this is why I sometimes just use it, even when I could do a side light finisher. For example, I'm neutral light, side light, and then I'm just. Oh wait, I have to turn the dodge off. So for example, when I'm doing when I do neutral light, side light, neutral light, no, neutral light, side light, neutral light, yeah. Or for example, just side light, neutral light, neutral light. Okay, you can follow up really good with the recovery after a neutral light finisher, and I almost every time I go for a recovery after a neutral light because that works really well. So just don't press any button and go to the right, and you will often just hit him. Because he maybe want to recover to the stage, and then he fast falls. Even and on higher damages, if he's I don't know, on a little bit higher damage, you can just jump and then go for recovery. And this also like works a lot. This really works a lot. So that's a really good follow-up option. Another option is to go for for neutral air, but I don't recommend this. Kind of hard to hit, and recovery is just better. So even after the recovery, you can continue with a neutral air. This is what I'm. When I hit the recovery, I jump or I chase dodge. And then I'm just doing a neutral air after this. And when I also hit the neutral air, then I'm jumping up again or chase dodging again. And then I'm doing a gravity cancel neutral stick. But this only works if the enemy fast falls. So it looks a little bit like this. Okay. You know, the thing is, the problem is the bot is not fast falling. So the normal player, yeah, of course, have another movement. So you will, you should just use this a lot against normal players to get a feeling of it. Because this will really help you. Oops. Or you can even do another. You can even just chase dodge and do another recovery. This also works. But this is, to do another recovery is worse than doing, for example, a gravity cancel side air. Or a gravity cancel neutral stick. And you can, you know, the thing about the gravity cancel side is you jump and you can like sometimes hit enemies if you could not hit them with your neutral stick, but you have to really get a feeling for this. So just play the weapon and you will get a feeling for all the air attacks and when to use which gravity cancel attack. You will get a feeling for this, I promise you. Okay, wait. Oops. Okay. Yeah, this the last gravity cancel side stick should be just a neutral stick. You know, often when I hit it my recovery and my neutral air, I also try to go for neutral stick because if the enemy then fast falls after the neutral air, then he will just fast fall directly into the neutral stick and then he's dead, and this can lead into zero to deaths. Like I had actually kind of a lot of zero to deaths through this. So yeah, if you just to remember, if you hit a side light neutral light finisher, always follow up with a recovery and then with a neutral air. And after that, you can maybe go for a gravity cancel neutral stick or a gravity cancel neutral light. Yeah, that's what I also wanted to say. I want to talk also about six and recovery. The six, yeah, so like down stick, just don't use it grounded. Down stick is slow, it has a lot of force, but it's not that good. You can get really hard punished for this. It has a lot of recovery frames. In the air, you can maybe use this, but I would not really recommend you to use this. I mean, actually, every of Clayton 6, I don't use really a lot of 6. The only stick I'm really using is the neutral stick, because it's quick, it's good, and yeah, a lot of force, good hitbox and everything, less recovery times than the other six. And I'm maybe using sometimes one or two times the side stick. Because side stick also has a lot of force, and if you just do it one time or something in the game, it's just like a surprise attack. You know, if they, for example, are on the dodge and you know they're going up then, and you hear, then you just chasing and then you just dodging to the right and then you just dash and sidestick. You see, this has enormous range and this comes so unexpected because you never use this, but only use this a couple of times. not spam this, because then the enemy will punish it really hard. Another thing I'm using like one or two times, like a surprise attack. If I, for example, hit a neutral side finisher, I love it to go for here to slide over to the edge and then do a side sig. Also in the air you can use this, but I recommend you to slide over to the edge so you have a little bit more boost and you can reach a little bit farther. Because if you just gravity cancel, because oh, I'm stupid. You see, then you just come from here to there. But if you are dodging, so then you're just sliding over to the edge and then you have a little bit more range. So if he tries to recover, then you can just throw out maybe side sig in the air. That's pretty good. But I would also don't spam this, because you can get definitely punished for this. It's strong, but if you always do this, then the enemy can just fast fall and then come from under you. For example, with hammer, then you just can recover you and then you're dead. That sucks. You don't want to be dead. So use this wisely. Use this as a surprise attack. Okay. Yeah, the neutral sig. I like a friend also told me, for example, if you're really on the edge of the map here, for example, and you hit a neutral light, a side light, and you know you're going, if you hit a side light, you're out of the range of the map, then you can just finish, then you can just follow up with a gravity cancel neutral sig. I don't practice this enough to really use in matches, so I'm not using this in matches, but I would strongly recommend you. I'm also going to learn this, because this is really strong. Oh yeah, and another thing which comes as a surprise attack sometimes: if your enemy is here and you want to recover and you're here, for example, just dodge into neutral sig. This really works also a lot, because if they see you dodge and if they see you dashing, then they maybe want to punish it from above, then they jump and try to punish you from here or something, for example. Or they just going up and then you also then you're already here, then it's too late for them. And even if they want to try to punish it from above, they just get hit by the end sig, and this also works a lot as a finisher move. I don't know. Yeah, I think I already said this, but this is really important and you should maybe really use this. It's easy and really good, unpunishable. Dodge, jump, recovery. It hits grounded. It's insane. It kills really early. You should definitely learn this, but you should not spam this, because this also can get punished if your enemies know what you're doing. This works also a lot, and I'm using this a lot. Yeah, then last point maybe, how to play in the air. You should maybe know, or like now you know it, greatsword is a grounded weapon. Okay, it's really, really, really good grounded. It's also good in the air. It has a good down air. It has pretty good side air. Also, if you don't go for side sig, for example, you can maybe go for jump, a dodge jump side air. It's really quick, and if you hit it on the edge of the map, it can also really good lead to kills. Like side air, you can really use this to edge guard. This is also something you should learn. Yeah, the point is that greatsword is definitely better on the ground, because you have a lot of approach options and you can just do all your combos on the ground. Okay, so it's really important. But if your enemies all the time in the air, it's not good to stay on the ground all the time. Then you like I'm also sometimes just jumping all the time and try to, for example, I'm also all the time dodge jumping then, and I'm moving here, and then sometimes I'm doing, for example, side air or down air and all down air and follow up with a neutral air then. But the most, like the part, the thing I'm doing the most in when I'm in the air is I'm waiting for the enemy maybe to attack me. I'm going to like a little, I'm just baiting him. I'm just baiting him a little bit. So he attacks, and then I'm try to dodge, and then I try to attack him. Then I try to attack him from the ground. So I'm fast falling, and then I'm really going to then I'm approaching him really fast. For example, with a neutral light, you can also approach with a down light, or if you're a little bit closer with a side light. With a side light. That's also really thing. Or if, for example, against Lance, this works really well, because Lance, you really have problems, for example, hitting neutral light because it's just outranging really hard. For Lance, I'm using a lot. Like that's a tip of me. For me, Lance, just try to stay above, and if it hits the ground, try to do a down air, and then you can just do a down air grounded. And you know, for example, if he dodges in, you can dodge back. It's the same thing with the dodge reads, as with the neutral light. You know, for example, he dodges in, for example, you dodge back, but oh no, he dodges away. Then you can just dodge down light to reach him. So basically, you also have an option to do. And I think that's it. I know it's going to be a very long video, maybe the longest Brawlhalla guide you've ever seen in your life, but I'm sure it's the most advanced Jayen guy on YouTube, because I pretty much watched every Jayen guy. I watched, like, I don't know, 40 videos or something about Jayen. But it doesn't, they all don't show those important things I'm showing. So I'm really doing maybe other videos about Greatsword for more advanced techniques, or I don't know, we can play together. I mean, it's basically my first video. I'm going to create a channel and everything, a new channel. But if I get a little bit of range, then we can maybe play together. Also, you can like add me. Yeah, my name is just Presti, Presti LP, everything together and everything small on Steam. So if you want to add me, or if you really just want to ask me something personal about Jayen, or if I just should help you to play Jayen, you can actually add me, and I'm going to accept you and help you. If surprisingly not, my video gets like, I don't know, 100,000 views, and I don't know, 500 people are adding me, then I maybe can't do it. It's for everybody. But yeah, I will see what I can do if you go, if you add me. Also, my Discord is, I can show you, is Presti #6880. Presti #6880. So you can add me. Yeah, these are just some screenshots from Brawlhalla. Yeah, that should be it for the guide. I hope you have a great day, and I hope you will have a lot of fun with Greatsword. Because if you know how to play with Greatsword, you're going to have a lot of fun. That's it from me. I wish you guys a good day, and see you in the next one.